And they bring it back here. The women that get married, they trick them into marrying them.
All right, that's my bus tonight.
It got here sooner than expected, but if
where
I
you
heard all the way out.
All right, man. All right.
My cousin acting up. He got switched white ride to school. He goes to the bridge.
Oh.
You already know.
This one got fucked up. It still works out.
We have all the wisdom in the world, but we're the most foolish people, man. The stupidest people in the world. Just watching the video with his sister. Just put crystal meth up her ass, man. Smiling on the camera like it's like a glorious thing, man. Like she done accomplished something. Medical breakthrough, and that's what, and I was, you know, people in the car, all the niggas was giving it thumbs up and shit, like, great job, sister. Black woman, yeah, black woman, man. Black woman, man. Stupid.
Ezekiel 37.
Ezekiel 37.
Yeah. I can read it. We asked the spirit. We just went into that on the show last week. Well, Friday. So really, that's why that also goes into, you know what I'm saying, teaching the gospel to the four corners of the earth. You got to bring all Israel back together.
Yeah, yeah.
I did that.
You know, see, everybody always talk about black unity. Let's unite. And here we're trying to unite. You know, but we already know that only the elect, which is a small number, is going to unite anyway. We're coming under that damn house. They should be out of shot. We unite under that now. You know, not under Eastern College. Not under, you know what I'm saying? Black
concert,
not in the fair
concert. I called my son because he's going to say he's running around with a phone call. I'm like, hold up. I snatched all his neck like,
give me that. I heard that.
Right.
Yeah.
Actually, we should read the whole 37th chapter.
Ezekiel 37.
Yeah, let's get it because this goes into these people out here. Ezekiel 37. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley which was full of bones and caused me to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry.
Very many in the open valley, it was dry bones.
Yeah,
this is it.
We had this truth. Yeah, this truth is life.
It's
all good. And he said unto me, son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. Again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of Yahweh. Thus said the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live.
And that breath of life.
Your mind will tell you all kind of crazy shit.
Right. Wicked shit.
You listen to your mind all the time, you be out of there. You be locked up. Everybody got a different heart too. Shit.
That's exactly like saying.
He said, why?
He's the word in the beginning.
Right.
Right. He
knew his job was coming to earth, right?
Right.
And when he was on the cross, why he asked him?
Because he was in this forsaken. Because he was in this earthly body.
And that was also, he quoted,
body, you know, which is subject to sin.
He quoted,
you know,
a song.
So he got weak at that moment, you know? But he still knew, but he still got weak because he in his fleshly body. He didn't inherit that spiritual body, you know what I'm saying?
That was also Psalm 22 he quoted. That was a song, Psalm 22. And you know, David, you know, he probably, that's pretty much a prophecy too, but that's why David was like,
I can catch the next one after this.
Yeah. Where you going, Tucker? Where you going there? Because if you stuck, man, I can take you home, man. For real, I'll take you home.
I'm right here to tell you.
Right, but check it out, man. You know, remember when the Lord, he went to the garden to pray?
Yeah.
He was weak then too. Sweating profusely because he knew he was about to go on the cross, man. He knew all the drama he was going to go through. He went to the Heavenly Father's man looking for another way, you know what I'm saying? He didn't want to go through that, man, because he's in this body, man. Nobody want to go through no fucking pain, being pierced and...
And it probably like they didn't know no bones would be broken on his mouth.
Huh?
Right. Yeah, that was the song.
They couldn't break his bones.
That's all the song's 22, yeah. Because they usually broke everybody's bones to make sure they was dead, but he was like, ah, he's already dead. So they didn't do it. That's what it is. I got a good precept real quick.
But like he said in the scriptures, man, he said, when he comes back again, I will not meet thee as a man. You know, he's not gonna come back in that same body where they can subdue him again. He's gonna come back in this whole full antelectic form, man. You know, spiritual power. Walking, well, you know, walking, and you on fire, you leaving footsteps, your foot burning, you know what I mean? This one, man, it's gonna be some horror, man. It's gonna be some terrifying shit, man.
Well, I'm not the body of Christ, right? It's the body of Christ. I'm thinking, you know what I'm saying? Maybe all our spirits are joined in one. You know what I mean?
We're all together.
You know what I mean?
Well, in one, one truth, in the truth. Everybody in the same mind.
Yeah, too, but you know what I'm saying? When you come back over, you know what I'm saying? We're like transformers, you feel me? Everybody all did come together.
Yeah, because the scriptures say that we're going to meet the Lord in the air, though, and we'll be changed.
Yeah.
It's going to be many. It's going to be like one person. Everybody's here.
Right.
The spirit indeed is willing.
But the flesh is weak. And when you read the Lord's Prayer also, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, we forget our debtors. Lead us not into temptation.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. You know what I'm saying? Because you see fat ass bitches who walk around with fat ass, big bumps, titties. You got a man. You gotta lead away from that, man. You gotta lead away from it. But if you experience a lot of bitches like me, man, you know that stink stay in your mind. That stinking pussy smell. You can. It's easy to remind you, guys. That bitch stinking, man. And it's easy for me. Just, oh man, fuck that wicked ass bitch.
Yeah, that's true though, man.
You know what I'm saying? Just some memories dealing with adulterous ass bitches because it comes with trouble, man.
Some of you might come out here, they try to do what's dirty out here. You gotta fight yourself if you wanna fight somebody or something, you know what I mean?
God, we're saying. You know, smack hit you.
Yeah,
that's
hard to do.
You know what I mean? But,
It'd be easy to hurt somebody.
A high spiritual level. Let me see you turn around.
That's hard to do.
You feel good about what? You know? Well, actually, that make a motherfucker feel worse, man. Here, motherfucker. Hit this one too.
Yeah, that's really talking about you doing your brothers like that.
Yeah, your brothers.
You never.
Yeah. Because you see, when they put the Lord on the cross, he wasn't fighting them. And the disciples didn't come start fighting for it. Yeah, that's why he said, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servants fight. When are they trying to save
me?
Oh yeah.
Everybody trying to make you believe, like I'm saying, queens and all these creatures. So I understand there is angels like that. I'm saying there, you know what I'm saying, like fucking angels or high up angels. But I believe angels just like nobody should look at Jacob rides with an angel. You know what I mean? Or you know what I mean? They try to have sex with an angel. I believe that they didn't do like that.
Right. Well, they do make themselves look through anything. They can change any forms they want.
They're like shapeshifters.
Look any. They can do whatever they want. They've got spiritual power, you know?
Hey, the Lord tell you the Lord himself is a, can change his appearance.
Let me show you something.
Remember after he got crucified, he came back, and he seen the disciples fishing, and they didn't even know who it was.
Yeah.
Until he started talking to them. They were like, oh, because he looked different. You know what I mean?
Here you go. This is Joe.
That bugged out.
This is Joe 2. I'm just going to start at 1. Again, there was a day when the sons of the Most High came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan came also among them to present himself before the Lord. And the Lord said unto Satan, from whence comest thou? And Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth. Satan be leaping from one.
We see Satan all the time.
You're right, it's constant.
You know, Satan himself, like you know what I'm saying? Christ himself? Or
we actually, one day,
we met them.
We know one day for sure we met Satan.
Right, because we ain't pushing the truth. And whenever the truth is out, Satan's, he's closed off.
Because a lot of times you got to ask, just like the Lord, we asked the demons what the name was. We asked dudes what his name was. And this dude was seriously possessed. Because one minute he was acting normal. We started hitting the scriptures. About a half hour later, he just started bugging out. Yeah, he started drooling. That was some crazy shit we ever seen.
Physically threatening us. Talking crazy.
And he started acting. First, he came out normal, like a normal person. He was, what did he, like an A-Rab or something?
Yeah.
And then he started saying his name was Satan. We had like, what's your name, baby? And he's like, Satan. He just started convulsing. It was crazy.
When Satan said the word, that means what?
Satan.
Yeah, that word means
the adversary.
Lucifer, right?
Nah.
We're Lucifer. Everybody.
But Lucifer means, that's a, that really the word Lucifer is not even in the Bible, actually. Because that's a Latin word. Because in the Hebrew, the word is halayah. How do you say halayah? Which means the enlightened, the exalted one.
You say he gonna be cast out, you know what I'm saying?
That's really tough. We could get into that.
You know what I mean? Like he's going to the bottom.
No.
Or he really literally wants something else.
Where's that at?
That's an Isaiah the 14th chapter.
Yeah, right.
That's actually talking about the original context. You can read it because it explains it. It tells you it's a man because originally it was the king of Babylon.
Right.
But now it applies to the so-called white man.
Same thing that he would have to be,
The devil was white. Lucifer.
Lucifer.
See,
right, yeah.
Right.
Lucifer. Yeah, because a lot of that's that Christian mythology. They said Lucifer got kicked out of heaven. No, they say his name was Lucifer. He got kicked out of heaven. Name was changed to Satan. Well, actually, that's in the book of Revelation. When he's going to, Michael and the archangels are going to fight against Satan, which is talking about the Roman Empire. When you look at the context of Revelation, and that's something that ain't even happened yet. They said there's going to be a war in the heavens. And that was a prophecy written in the book of Revelation, which means.
The spaceship's
going up there
trying to
check
it out.
Right, well, yeah, right, exactly. That's what it is.
It's
Satan fighting with the angels in the air.
Here we go. Isaiah 14. I'm going to start at, no, I can't start there. Start at 9. Hail from beneath is moved for thee to meet thee at thy coming, and stirreth up the dead for thee. Even all the chief ones of the earth, it have raised up from the thrones all the kings of the nations.
The chief ones of the earth. Go ahead. Not the angels and the... Get that fallen angel thing, that's that mythology, you know what I mean?
All they that speak and say unto thee, art thou also become weak as we?
Yeah.
Art thou become like unto us? Thy talk is brought down to the grave, and the noise of thy vials, the worm is spread under thee, and the worm covereth thee. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
O Lucifer.
Son of the morning. How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations?
Yeah, that right. What's up?
What's up, man?
So, yeah, so
you just got out?
Oh,
we ain't seen you in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, but guess what?
You got something for me?
Got it.
Okay.
but look, it said the Lucifer weakened the nations.
Just weakened.
And notice he said, "Oh, Lucifer." Because like I said, in Hebrew, it don't say Lucifer. It says Hallel. Something like that. I'm probably saying it wrong. That's where you get the word hallelujah. You share the same word, which means exalted. So the Lord's like mocking you. You know how you're being sarcastic with someone?
Yeah, like somebody used to call the Christians. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It was like a my nigga, you know what I'm saying, back in the day. So I'm saying, oh, they following Christ and they Christians.
Yeah. Same thing. So he's saying, oh, Lucifer, you so great, you so atoned. That's how he's saying it. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer? Which did weaken the nation.
So, you know, this is all talking about the king of Babylon. Because the king of Babylon, that was that first beast that was prophesied. Right? And that's the beast that weakened all the nations. They conquered all the surrounding nations.
The original Babylon?
The kingdom of Babylon, about 500 B.C. Yeah. Around there.
We come in the spirit of prophecy.
Yeah. So, okay. There's no new thing under the sun, so yeah, we knew the new Babylon, so now this applies to Esau. Go ahead.
For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven.
Now, if that was Satan get kicked out of heaven, why is he going to ascend into heaven? No, that don't make sense.
I thought before the flood, they was able to go back and forth.
Yeah.
I'm
sure they can do that right now.
Yeah.
You talking about the angels?
Yeah.
Did you see he just read the book of Job, and the book of Job was written way after the flood, and Satan was reported to the Most High.
Yeah, he stayed until his day. He got to.
You know what I mean?
He's in order. Yeah. He's never out of order.
Yeah.
He sent against us. He was given the scripture. You know, he's only doing what he's told. For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven, I will exalt my throne above the stars of the Most High.
And that's what the so-called white man just said. But his name is Esau. Yeah. He wanted to go out, he got his Hubble telescope. He's trying to search out the heavens.
They don't give it up one day.
Yeah, that's why we are here.
They're closing slowly.
The Lord is long.
I will exalt my throne above the stars. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the cloud. I will be like the Most High.
That's what they do today. They think like God.
You know, you see. City over there in the east where they got the coffee in the clouds. Rich Abraham, remember I was telling you about
the
rich that coffee in the clouds. They got the buildings so high up.
They're talking about Dubai?
Dubai.
A lot of the Muslims over there in like Saudi Arabia, they swear. They say that the Saudi Arabian royal family are crypto Jews. You know what I mean? They're secret. They claim to be Ishmaelites, but secretly they're actually Edomites. But they're ruling over Ishmaelites, just like the Rothschilds.
Yeah.
You know, I got a better example. The Rockefellers. The Rockefellers pretended to be good Christians. But really, when you look into the history, they're actually crypto Jews or Edomites.
Their last name used to be Bowers.
So you got a lot of it because that was popular back in the early 20th century. Jews, because back in the day, people knew about they were some very fast guys. So they had to change their last name. Just like Stan Lee from Marvel Comics. You know, he could actually be a Jake. But he changed his name. His last name is really Lieberman. Yeah, but they're all Jews, though, you know what I mean? Or Edomites, or I think Stan Lee's actually Jake, though.
He's definitely Jake.
Yeah.
Yep. thou shalt be brought down from hell to the salt of the pit. They that see thee shall merrily look upon thee and consider thee sane.
Now look, they gonna look on Lucifer, consider them sane. Go ahead.
Is this the man?
Is this the man?
Is this the man?
So Lucifer's a man.
Yeah, he's right there.
Yeah, that's
Yeah. Is this the man?
Yeah, that's David D. Rothschild.
Which one?
Yeah, reincarnation.
Oh, okay.
That's the son.
It looks just like him. You look at a picture of him.
Exactly like him.
He's probably one of the most powerful men in the world.
That they pay on. Yeah. They
on. What I'm talking about, because he's the young one now. He's the one with all the strength and energy. You know what I mean?
Right.
Because his dad's all old.
Is this the man that made the earth to tremble? That did shake kingdoms? So he's talking about a man?
Yeah, he's talking about man.
Not the spiritual being
so
Satan.
Who's shaking the kingdoms now? You know what I mean?
Satan destroyed this whole planet.
They say he's on a boat.
I mean, who are you talking about? The spiritual being?
The spiritual being.
That's something.
Yeah. Hey, Christopher.
He's talking about everywhere.
Yeah, he is everywhere.
He's everywhere.
Somebody's going to bring him a household, a marriage. You know, he loves love that more than he loves. Kill somebody.
Hey, there is some bucked out shit to that we're trying to go.
There's something wrong with that, but you know.
And hey, Christopher Columbus was over there. He said a UFO. He said a chariot.
Yeah, but what is it? Most I said don't make no graphic images and don't make nothing, don't put pictures of what's in heaven and below the sea.
And
below the sea.
Yeah, because them chariots don't
below
want
the
water
sea
too.
Though. You know what I'm saying?
They got videos.
We've seen it. Below the sea,
that's where Leviathan is. Yeah, we got Leviathan. But you seen it.
Because a nigga make a statue of Leviathan and worship that motherfucker. You know, you know what niggas do. A nigga,
so worship. So it's a civilization underwater.
Nah, it's where the Lord got the shit laid. You know, not no civilization, because that's how they try and teach you that hollow earth theory.
Yeah, but you know there are videos of though the chariots are just going straight from the water. They go in the water. See what I mean? So you don't know what they're doing down there.
Or the actual reality is like strange things.
Yeah.
But all that flat earth thing.
Flat earth, that's a
The kingdom's gonna come land on earth, basically, right?
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? To get into that kingdom, you gotta know what gate, right? It's gonna be 12 gates.
What's that? Revelation 3. Oh, yeah, he gotta get that good
stuff. Hey, let me get this,
though. He's like, oh, look.
Get them, man. How much are these?
There's five of them.
I was like,
what are you saying about
them?
Let me get those for somebody else.
Yeah, like, 12 gates, you gotta know what gate you gotta go to. You know what I'm saying? So, Judah, you gotta know Judah. You know what I'm saying? We don't get
nobody else's gate. That's all, like, the 12 gates. That's a lot of symbolism, too. Yeah, right, it's all about Israel. It's all about Israel. Because.
When
the Lord returns, he's going to put in everybody's spirit. We're going to live with you.
No, you know, man.
But like you said, there is that gate. The gate is your house.
Like five for that. I got you.
For that dollar. It's going to be 12 angels at the gates.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? And then the names, you know what I'm saying? They blot your name. They blot it out. The sins can be blotted out.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what we talk about in New Jerusalem.
Hey.
Uh-oh. I'm leaving my black bag here.
Okay, oh, let me bring her over here, man. You know I'm over here.
Uh-oh, so you got some precepts for you. You got some precepts. Let's get it. Get that Daniel, boy.
You talking about Daniel?
I was about to get that.
Daniel 2 and 44. And in the days of these kings shall the Most High of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed.
That's beautiful.
And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Oh.
Who's all other people, man? Who are those other people, man?
It shall not be left to other people. You said what? It's actually like a shade of brown.
It's black.
Yes.
Well, that was because of my age.
Spirit out here for it really is.
So why did he have devil horns?
This one was the devil. That was him right here.
The Revelation 10, I'm talking about the preaching of the word.
Say that man gets the third chapter, fifth chapter of Revelation.
You better get off the
ground. They say he was black. They say he was black. My dad. I'm considered a black.
Amos 9:8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are upon the sinful kingdom.
What's that sinful kingdom? America.
And I will destroy it from off the face of the earth.
And that's what we're hoping for and praying for.
Yeah, every day. Y'all supposed to be praying for that too.
Everybody. Everybody.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
Right. The kingdom ain't gonna come until this place is destroyed. It's not gonna come until this place is destroyed. Okay, my man, go ahead.
I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, saving. I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, save the Lord. For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel from among all nations. Like a, let me finish the rest of it.
Some Israelites is walking around thinking they're Chinese.
There's some Israelites walking around thinking they a so-called white man. You hear what I'm saying? Because they're living amongst them. Because the Lord scattered us for being wicked. So he's going to come and deliver us in these last days, you know?
That's why the Lord said you got to teach the gospel to all nations, to the four corners of the earth.
That's right, bro.
One more time, the movie's called What?
What the hell?
It's Tobit 13:3. Confess him before the Gentiles, ye children of Israel.
Confess him before the Gentiles. Go ahead.
For he hath scattered us among them.
So the Lord scattered us among the Gentiles. So that's why you can't be judging people just by appearance and where they're from. You gotta be spiritual in all things you do. Hey, keep reading that.
It says, dare declare his greatness.
Dare declare his greatness.
All right, dare declare his greatness and I saw him before all the living, for he is our Lord and he is the God of our Father forever.
Yeah, he's the God of our Father forever. The Lord is great, so you gotta exalt him. That also proves you gotta come out here and do this work. For a, you know, a man is supposed to come out here and do this work. A woman don't gotta come out here.
How old are you?
How old are you?
18.
You know, you're a man when you turn 12 years old, according to the scripture.
I'm 18. I don't look real short, I know. But, yeah.
Okay, sure. I'm a kid.
You said your mom's black, right? Your mom's Jake. I know she's Jake, but I already know.
That's the spirit.
I already know, though. You know, because they don't even mice really out here making babies with us, man. That's very rare. That's very rare.
Those white women are attracted to black men. Yeah, because they all go back to the same people.
That's right.
That's all spiritual.
That's, you know what, that's why a lot of these white folks is hanging out down here. That's why all these white folks hanging out. Some of them are devils, though.
Yeah, but you don't know the devil, the spirit from
trying to go there.
You're saying that man is that man.
Yeah.
And that man was evil.
Both of them.
What's the problem?
Both of them.
You know the one that did the 16 chapters?
Both of them.
Oh, yeah.
Leonardo.
That was Michelangelo.
Michelangelo
did a 16 chapter.
Yeah, Michelangelo.
Yeah.
He's the one that painted snakes. He had Jesus portrayed looking like this.
And you know your boy T.D. Jakes dropped dead in his sleep.
He did?
The other day, yeah. In his sleep, they say he passed away peacefully.
Oh, my.
T.D. Jakes died?
No.
Yeah.
T.D. Snakes.
He
turned the word of the Lord into a business.
A prophet. Bro.
He even said it. They got a video where he said it.
Did he even die?
I didn't hear about that.
Really died? Yeah.
He got to praise the Lord for
that.
Hey, get that Daniel down.
Romans 8:14. Romans 8:14. As many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God.
Yeah, so you know who's the sons of God? Is Israel?
Israelites.
That's a synonym. A synonym for Israel is son of God.
That's it. That's it.
I told y'all.
We awake now.
Thank you.
Well, I did wake y'all up.
He woke us up. Shame shall cover the next day. Boy, it's coming quick. The shame. When they ought to be in order, with their mouth shut, but busy running their mouth.
Have a good day.
All right,
you know, I still stay in my room. Thank you.
Lord gonna kill old and young. He gonna kill old motherfuckers too. Man. They think they're so goddamn wise and full of knowledge. But they ain't nothing but walking fools, man. You know, walking fools.
That's why you can't get too mad at the old lady. You already know the woman brings confusion. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
She
has something
like you can't get mad.
Y'all can have some people like
this. Yeah. Because you already know she's crazy as hell. You know what I mean? This is my dude right here.
No, I just bought him.
He's beating it, man. He got to get his fix.
Like,
he's talking to me. He's supposed to be hungry or something.
keep the truth as far away from her as you can. All right. Keep it away from you. You already know.
Yeah, because a woman, man.
She just wants somebody to hang out with.
Good at teaching your woman and stuff. I mean, it's good at teaching little basic stuff.
Right, that didn't come, though. Not off the bat.
Because we ain't in that time right now for the...
Right. After you hit it a few times, they're going to be more humble. If you ain't hit it, you're going to be more humble. More humble.
Most of the time, women just going to leave you anyway. Like, oh, you crazy, motherfucker. Come out of here. There's some few women out there that not really big. This is for men, you know?
Oh, no, he just kept moving.
That's the best way to be, is quiet.
That's how you learn.
That's how you learn.
Yeah. 2 years.
We ask questions, too.
He ain't talking about 30 years. This is the 30 years.
What's up,
Christ?
Some people got sodomites in their family, right? But that's my brother, that's my sister, you know? But the Lord said he's going to kill a sodomite, you know? He's going to kill him. He's going to kill him. Stop being a faggot. Stop being a faggot. That's the way out.
I mean, the Lord said he forgive all manner of sin.
That's right.
You forgive anything but blasphemy the Holy Spirit.
Right.
So, I mean, you could be a murderer. You could have done kill people.
A murderer. Right, but I ain't saying go commit murder.
Nah, the people are running with that one. Nah, but for real though, the Lord is merciful, man.
So is it that we change or is it that God changed?
Well, yeah.
Well, God changed. God is because the Lord got put spirit on you. You know, you can't just come to the Lord. You got to
change. There ain't no such thing as free will. Yep. You know, everything you do, every last thing that happens is all controlled by the Spirit.
Everyone makes choices.
You got the illusion of a choice. It's an illusion of a choice.
So I ran out on the street, that means
a demon got in your mind to come out with
that. I mean, you'll get bugged out thinking about it. Because the comprehend that there's no free will is bugged out. Go ahead.
This is Job 33:14. For the Most High speaketh once, yea twice, yet man perceiveth it not. You know,
like I said, you can't understand the concept that there's no free will. Right.
For the Most High speaketh once, yea twice, yet man perceiveth it not. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men and slumberings upon their beds, then he openeth the ears of men and sealeth their instructions. You know, some people just wake up one day, ain't full of money, but they still wake up. I just mean their kids just committed adultery. I'm gonna kill her and the children.
They put the spirit on you. Yeah. They programmed you.
Wait, what is it saying?
It's saying that angels programmed you. Listen. Then he openeth the ears of men and sealeth their instruction.
I got it.
Your instructions. What you gonna do? Because we're all robots.
Yeah, pretty much.
We're all robots. Huh? You don't have a child. Okay. Right. The Lord gave him the program. He used me to give that program to that child.
Well, like I said, you'll get bugged out thinking about it.
If he don't do it, he's going to get his ass whooped until he do it.
So look, tell me what this means.
What's that?
Tell me if there's a choice in this right here.
That's right.
John 15:16. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. But he said, ye have not chosen me, but the Lord has chosen you. So what is that? Is that a choice?
God chose me.
No, but it say you can't choose the Most High. It says you got to be chosen. So is that you making a choice?
What does it say before?
Yeah, look, bro, I'm just going to read it again. It says, "You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you." Just look. During the Exodus. You know the story of the Exodus? So what happened? Moses kept going to the Pharaoh to say, what? Let my people go, right? And the scriptures kept saying, and the Pharaoh wanted to let the people go, but he hardened his heart. So there's no...
That's control.
That's control.
That's total control. But check this out.
So let me ask you this. What is faith?
Right. Is everybody right now? Is everybody right now?
So look, because the scriptures say how marvelous the Most High's ways are past. You can't find out, figure out the mind of the Most High. You'll get bugged out, go crazy trying to think
about
it.
Hey, check this out, bro. This is Romans 1, and I'm going to start at 30:21. Because of that, when they knew the Most High, they glorified him not as the Most High, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and in their foolish hearts were darkened. Professing themselves as wise, they became fools and changed the glory of the uncorruptible Most High into an image made like a corruptible man, into birds and fearful beasts and creepy things. Wherefore the Most High also gave them up to uncleanness.
So I mean, they made the choice, but at the end of the day, the Most High put it in them to do that.
Because so remember, there was a time when these people rejected the Christ, the Lord when they walked the earth.
I got another one.
Wait, there's another story. The story about the serpents, right? Remember, Israel sinned, and then God was like, all right, I'm going to send these snakes. He moved his hand from them. He wasn't there, and the snakes came and bit them. What the most?
He built this, the bronze serpent. And whoever looked at it,
he
was cured.
He raised his staff.
Yeah.
So, he said, whoever looks at it, he say, wait. Bro, they be healed. So they had a choice to look.
He ain't get what I'm saying. Lord makes you do what you do, man.
Right. Before you do it, he's already made up in your mind to do it.
I got a good precept for you. This is bring a lot of understanding. For, Ephesians 1:4. Actually, let me start at 3. Blessed be the God of our Father, of our Lord, Jesus Christ. And we know his real Hebrew name is Yahweh Shah. Okay, it's not Jesus. Who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. And you know, Hebrew Christ is Mashiach, which we get the word Messiah. According as he hath chosen us in him. Now listen, he hath chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Yahweh Shai to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will. So he was predestinated, chosen before the world was even formed. So that there's no choice. We was chosen before the earth was created.
We're all chosen.
All is not chosen. All is not chosen. You go to church, right? Yeah, that's why you're confused right now.
The Lord said many are called, but...
confusion, man. They teach it falsehood. They're not even teaching the scriptures, man. That's why right here you don't know nothing, man. You know nothing. What's that? What is that? Come on, man. What is it?
That's supposed to be the mark of choice.
Okay, where is that in the scriptures?
Mark of the beast. I said like that.
No,
so it ain't real? You don't believe in the mark of the beast?
No, I believe in the mark of the beast. Right. It says that people are sealed on their hands and foreheads.
Yeah.
The mark.
Right.
It's your mark.
What's that mean?
The mark that means you choose to follow.
Angels put it in your mind.
That ain't what that means, because if that was the case, because it said, because the scriptures say, if the mark was like sin or whatever you're trying to say, that would mean...
No, they said it was you choose to follow. You willingly follow the beast.
But when we all grew up, we was all following the beast. That means we all got to die. Because it says whoever takes a mark is going to eat missiles and die in the fire.
So it's going to be a physical mark that's going to get inside of you.
They had the mark on you right now. They said buy and sell, right?
I meant we have the Lord. We have faith. People without the mark have what they call faith.
There's two things. Either your mark or your what?
That's a different kind of mark.
There's two different kind of marks. There's a mark of being, having the truth and accepting it and embracing it.
Look, like on that sign right there. It. You can read that sign. It's got the Greek word
Ezekiel
for mark.
9.
The Greek word for mark is.
No, I don't let nobody touch my mark.
You can't touch your mark?
No, you can't touch my Bible. You might have demons.
Ain't you got an e-Bible?
Demons e-Bible? Love going
to your body
to the next.
Digital man. Bible on your phone?
Right. Right. My phone's dying.
There's two things. Y'all look
up. Hey, you trying to take your oil, bro.
Right. Oh, man. Take some of my oil. You said virgin oil, too.
The extra virgin.
I guess that's an easier one.
No, man. You can just.
I got to go get my Bible.
Go get it, man. We ain't going nowhere. If you love the Lord, you're going to go get it and come back, man. You said you love the Lord.
I'll be right back.
No, you ain't.
I'll be right back. I promise you.
Okay.
Get out of here.
Get out of here. What's the chair, man? That's why I'm going to the other side.
Go through this midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sighed at God.
We're signing and crying.
Yep.
Right? Yes, they are. No.
For all the abominations that we've done in the midst of
them. Right, he's using that word mark. Because that word mark in the Hebrew.
Oh, don't tell me it's
on his phone. Oh, my goodness.
How convenient.
But it's two totally different words, though, that mark. So I guess the gospel of Mark, that's a mark, too.
Right. Oh, right.
You know what I mean?
He tried to say, we all got mark.
Yeah.
That don't, yeah.
I don't know what the fuck you're trying to say.
That don't make sense.
Because they beast of the chip.
Because people always try to
say, you know what I'm saying? It's in this country.
People always try to say it's sin or something.
All right, here we go. Remember, it's a mark on what?
So, but hold up, though.
Revelation 7. Read it. I like when people read it.
No, it's called the mark of the beast. That means it's different from the other things. You know what I mean? This is one mark, and this is the mark of the beast. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. He's talking about mark for you. Let me read the scripture. Ezekiel 9:4, and Yahweh said unto them, go through the midst of the city.
Mr. Columbus.
This is the set of mark.
Not the physical.
Jerusalem is a people before it's a place. That's why the Lord said, oh, Jerusalem, thou that killest the prophets. Refer to a people. Because it's a people first.
Because the Lord ain't come to save people. That's what they is.
Christos!
So wait, Christos. That means what's your question?
Luke. Yeah, Luke going to have. Luke's out here on the highways and byways, pushing the word down. Luke's back in reincarnation, pushing the word down.
Look at the Israelite. He's not.
What was it?
What?
From where?
Hebrew is a Gentile. We are Gentiles right now. Hebrew is set to work with the Most High's word. So we are Hebrew Israelites right now.
You sure about that? Can you prove it with the script?
He's a Gentile.
A Gentile? What? There's the word Gentile is not even in the Bible.
It is.
It is in the English Bible. Is it in the original text?
No, I mean, when I say Gentile.
Gentile is a Latin word. The Bible wasn't written in Latin.
He was not of the Hebrew.
Yeah, he was. Where was he from then? Where is he from? Was he a so-called Greek? Let me read you something real quick. Let me read a scripture for you. 1 Corinthians 12:1. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. But a lot of people seem to be quite ignorant. Said ye know that ye were Gentiles.
Gentile's not a word. It's not in the Bible.
I said it's not in the original text. Actually, if I said like the original word is ethnos, it means nations. It says ye know, or of the other nations. Ye know that ye were Gentiles carried away unto these dumb idols even as you were led. So what does that mean, ye were Gentiles? And it said carried away unto these idols. Carried away from where? From where? No, no, no. It said you were Gentiles. You became a Gentile because you got carried away unto the idols. Where did they get carried from? But what's... No. It said Gentile. You get into their Israelites, they lost their identity. They lost their heritage. I'll get another scripture.
Hey, let me read this real quick. This is Galatians 3:7.
Oh, that's a good one.
Know ye therefore that they which are of faith, the same are the children of Abraham.
See? Children of Abraham.
Galatians 3:7. Verse 8, and the scriptures foreseeing that the Most High would justify the heathen through faith, preached before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, in thee shall all nations be blessed. So then they which be of faith are blessed.
Because Israel scattered among all nations. Israel scattered to the four corners of the earth. Look, that's why this is written. This is why Paul said this in the book of 1 Corinthians. And who is the book of Corinthians written to? The Hellenes. The so-called Greeks living in Corinth, right? And the Hellenes were Israelites, okay? That's why the Greek got an alphabet that come from Hebrew. So the Greek alphabet is a Hebrew, come from Hebrew. Look, 1 Corinthians 10:1. More, he gonna keep saying this. Moreover, brethren, I would not that you should be ignorant. Once again, he said that. I would not that you should be ignorant how that all our fathers, he said all our fathers, were under the cloud and all passed through the sea and were all baptized under Moses in the clouds and in the sea and did all eat the same spiritual meat and did all drink the same spiritual drink, for they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Yahweh Shah. So it said all our fathers crossed through the Red Sea.
We're baptized.
So who's our father? Who crossed through the Red Sea? Right. And that's it. So the one all nations. So this telling you that these Corinthians were actually Israelites.
Now it's time to come back. You know what I'm saying? Everybody can be saved. You do that? You think everybody can be saved? Everybody can be saved.
The Lord even self said many are called, but few are chosen.
Say you're gonna destroy a whole race of people.
Yep.
So how can they be saved? You're gonna destroy all the Edomites.
The Lord don't change.
With the Edomites, what is that? That is.
We just told you Israel got scattered.
That's what we're talking about. That's right.
My brother likes me like me, right? My brother likes me like me. My father way black. My brother likes me like me, but his baby mom is super, super light skinned. My nephew, my little son, he look like
that's asking.
Right,
my oldest son. You should see my oldest son. I don't even got a picture of him, man.
But it's a spirit, bro.
Here you go. This is 2 Esdras 8:1. And he answered me saying, the Most High have made this world for many, but the world to come for few.
Wow, few don't sound like everybody.
Right. I will tell thee a similitude, Esdras, as when thou askest the earth, it shall say unto thee, that have given much mold whereof the earthly dust is made, and little dust that the gold comes of, even so is the course of this present world. There be many created, but few shall be saved.
Many created, but few shall be saved.
We're trying to get up out of here. And that's why we out here trying to get others, the elect, up out of here too, you know? We ain't just trying to get everybody, we're just only the elect, man. This ain't for everybody, this is for the elect. And that's what's beautiful about this gift, that this gift is given to a few. We be on fire when we give this great message to people, man.
What about homosexuality? It's an abomination. You think
a
homosexual can make it to the kingdom?
Ain't no motherfucking niggas gonna be going to hold hands,
man.
You my book, baby.
What you want first
John? Man,
what
you
say
first John?
The Lord said it.
What is the same thing?
Know you not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
Unrighteous.
Do not deceive.
I mean, they can repent from that. I mean, it's not likely, but they can.
You gotta stop now. Now if you heard his rule, you gotta stop. But if you just deny the word anyway, he don't mean that, then you already doomed, man. You doomed.
Do not deceive. Fornicators, adulterers, effeminate.
That's effeminate. That's a lot of sex. It sounds like the LGBT community. With flags running around in their car, in their houses, stickers and shit.
Abusers.
Going up the man, it's popular amongst some motherfuckers. They like fisting each other, man. What's up with a fist, though?
Is it because they,
A fist? Some motherfuckers got big ass hands like Johnny, man. Johnny got them. We are continuing. This is Leviticus 20:13. Man also lied with mankind, as he lied with a woman. Both of them have an abomination. They shall surely be put to the death. Their blood shall be.
What about Romans 1? Romans 1 and that proves there's no free will too.
I'm just gonna read that.
In 1 John says that if you whoever sins is not a God.
Whoever no law taught the lie.
Hey, it's 1 John, I'll go ahead.
1 John 1 and 9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just.
That's what we was just saying. You confess your sins, the same thing as repentance.
What?
He cleansed you from all unrighteousness.
So who's going to cleanse us?
We just said that.
Right, right.
Okay, but you got to stop from the homosexuality. You can't keep on doing it. Should we sin that grace may abound? And what is sin?
Sin is...
You're in 1 John.
Sin is what?
Sin is...
Yeah,
exactly.
Listen to this, bro.
We're trying to inform whosoever committed sin can transgress also the law.
You going?
Well, sin is the transgression of the law.
Sin is the transgression of the law.
Read a law by
sin. Just telling you, something like this, bro. You do it, you out of here. Simple as that. Ain't no love for you. I'm saying when the Most High come back, bro, you're not spirit, you're out of here. The Most High sent me back.
Hey,
you.
Get you one couple of First John.
I got another one.
I'm
saying nothing for homosexuality, bro. In the eyes of the Most High, man. I got another one. It's abomination. You can't do it, bro.
So what is what's the worst sin you said?
Yeah,
the worst sin is the transgression of the laws.
Hey, we got this another one in 1 John.
Okay, let's just go straight up.
I'll go ahead.
Straight up. You say fire.
You commit one sin, so I kill the person I'm just as worse as
of course.
Any error, there's no.
But look, let's do this. But like we already said, all sin can be forgiven except for blasphemy of the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
But however, we do. Go ahead.
1 John 5:16. If any man see his brother sin is sin which is not unto death, he shall ask and he shall give life to him that sin not unto death.
Now what's a sin unto death? He just read one in Leviticus. Adultery is a sin unto death. Homosexuality is a sin unto death. Murder. Listen, murder is a sin unto death. Certain sins, according to the law of Moses, you gotta get put to death for. You see what I'm saying? Go ahead, read that.
If any man sin. If he may see his brother sin is sin which is not unto death, he shall ask, and he shall give him life for them that sin unto death.
Yeah, you're supposed to pray
for
him. Go ahead.
He's going to tell you that's the sin. Exactly the same thing we're doing. We're doing just that right now.
You know what Bonix is? It's speaking the way we speak, you know what I'm saying, now. The hood, you know what I mean? To me, that's what I hear the Bible saying. It's telling you off rip, like, bro. You know what I'm saying? I say you're being gay, you know what I'm saying? It's on me, too, if I don't tell you.
That's right.
I'm saying you are.
That's exactly what we're doing.
But no, he ain't finishing, though. Keep going. Now you go.
There is a sin unto death.
Now listen, there is a sin unto death.
I do not say that. He shall pray for it.
So, hey, you're not supposed to pray for something. You're not, because you justify wickedness, man.
Whoever is born of God sinned not.
Whoever is born of God sinned not. Right. Which means you're trying your best, because none of us are perfect, but you're going to try your best to keep on them, to keep them calm.
Keep them demons off you, man.
But the wicked one touches him not.
Yeah, so that, like the Lord's Prayer, like the brother, the lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. We try and get delivered from evil, not trying to embrace the evil. You know what I'm saying?
What is your point, though?
Man, he's trying to open the door for fast. The door ain't gonna be open to homosexuals. It's just not gonna open. It's not.
The Lord said you gotta walk that straight gate.
Right. You're a difficult path. Stop living in the lust of the flesh.
Yeah, that's the lust of the flesh, bro.
Right. Stop living in that lust. Turn around. Right. Yeah, hopefully, so right.
I mean, so they give you a heart feel, hopefully they don't have it. So you know what's wrong.
Right, the love of God. Love of God is keeping this commandment.
The truth.
No, that's what the love of God means.
The truth.
No, the word love of God. If you love God, this is what I say. He say, if you love God, bro, he said, keep my commandments.
Hey,
you ain't keeping the commandments and you don't love God.
Yeah, man.
With all your heart. You might say you do, but you don't.
What is this?
You're not loving your brother by exploding his anal cavity.
There's 10 commandments, right?
No. Right. No. Let me just the 10 that you know about.
That's the 10 most important.
13 laws.
Those are the laws that first
of all, that God. We're under all these laws. Christ came to check this out. This is Baruch 4:1. This is the book of the commandments of the Most High. And the law that endureth forever.
The law that
endureth forever.
Look, I'm going to hit you with, there's a law that's not the Ten Commandments that says you're not supposed to steal a man and sell him. So that's not in the Ten Commandments, though. You know what I mean? There's
a daughter?
I got all that. I mean, when we under curses, bro, I ain't got big bank that can go live my own house.
You ain't supposed to have no crazy woman.
I don't got big bank. You know, we working on it. We working on getting
all
three. We
all
sin. But we're rehearsing the righteous acts, though.
Right, like the brother said, we under grace.
What is grace? Let me ask you, what is grace?
Grace is like this. If I spoke to you and he caught me and I said, I'm sorry.
No, I ain't gonna forgive you.
That's not grace.
No. That's not grace.
No. Grace is a time period. If I say like this, one time, like a cell phone, like you call, say, the phone got cut off. You call and ask me to get a couple more days.
They call it a grace period.
It's a grace period. That's what we're under now.
Beautiful.
Grace.
That's nice.
We're under grace period right now, so you only got a little bit of time to change your ways, dude. Because if you're doing what you're doing, you get to a kingdom gate, and I'm right there, it's not happening.
You can't get your hand cut off.
I mean, because the Most High command me to tell you no.
No, he can command you to cut his head off.
There you go.
Especially.
Right.
Especially you got rebuked by men of the Lord.
We're just being keeping real, man. That's what the men of the Lord do. We keep it real and uncut.
The Lord said
unedited.
He chastises who we love.
That's right.
Right.
Let me finish this. Let me finish this.
Correcting people.
All they that keep it shall come to life, but such as leave it shall die.
They're talking about the law, right?
That's right.
But we know we're not saved by the law. You get saved by your faith. But however, the law is there. Just look, I'm a
shower shot. Shower shot.
Sweet Jesus. Sweet Jesus.
Go ahead.
I took claim of that a couple months ago.
Is that wrong?
Love worketh no ill to his neighbor. And actually, you know what? You know in the Greek Testament, in the Greek language, there's actually like three different words used for love. And when it's talking about the love of God and the love of your brothers and work, it's agape.
Sweet
agape
Jesus! Brothers.
But the other one is philo, like philosopher. It means to like. You know what I'm saying? But the word agape, it means it's dealing with the love of God, meaning the, keeping the law and the ways of the Most High in a righteous manner. It's a different type, because you know, the English word is good.
God is good.
Y'all hear that word?
He looks out for me.
There you go.
Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law.
Yeah, love is the, because at the end of the day, the law is that it helps. Like the law said, don't eat pork. Why? Just look around, you see all these obese people, bro. All these 300, 400 pound women, they eat pork.
Chicken and pork, and I'm like, whoa, man, I'm frozen, whoa. Man, I'm mad as heck, man. Like,
so that's why you know, the law can't save you, but it's there to help you. Because the scripture said the law is a schoolmaster. It teaches you about, you know, what's right and
wrong. Paul said if it wasn't for the law,
here you go. This is Luke 6 and 46. And why call ye me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say? Going through that for the longest.
Matthew 5 through 7.
Let's read Matthew 5 and 17.
No, Matthew 5 through 7. That's all it is.
Matthew 5, 6, and 7.
No, those are the things that he is. So it was, and he said, he asked them, what is the greatest commandment? Right? What is the greatest commandment? Asked
the greatest commandment. Said, don't take people God before you. Simple as that. You know what I'm saying? The greatest commandment, don't put up God before him and love your neighbor like you love yourself. You know what I'm saying?
Brother, it's love, right?
Your neighbor, not for everybody.
It's teaching
the Hebrews. Who was he talking to when he said that? He said, show love to the Hebrews, not everybody. Fuck her. Fuck all you hunkies. All you hunkies, you know what I'm saying? For real, bro.
Listen. Exodus 20 and 1. And the Most High spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy power, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods.
Hey, look, I got one for you. This is red letters. Now we're going to get John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
That means that they have a choice.
Right? Listen, just listen. There's no choice. But listen, I'm not done. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already.
So you got to believe the whole book, not some of the book.
The whole book.
So the Lord says, someone don't believe on him, they condemn.
So I have a choice. I have no choice.
You got a choice, but if you
do. No.
You don't got a choice. Either you believe it, you're going to be saved.
So let me ask you a question. A non-believer, are they or are they not condemned?
They're condemned.
Let me keep going. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Listen, and this is the condemnation that has come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in the Most High.
And that light is truth.
That light is the truth.
The truth.
So that anyone who
accepts Christ. Not some of the truth.
Anyone who accepts Christ.
But clearly,
when Moses was talking, who was he talking to? Who did Christ deal with? Who did he come to say?
What is it?
We're not coming to the world, right?
No. Whosoever. It's the same people he's talking to right there. He's saying, whosoever believes him. And don't forget, we turned it to Gentiles. Feel me? He's talking. That's the wicked brother. That's the wicked twin brother.
Hey, that's Cain.
That's the evil twin brother.
Cain. That's Cain right there,
him
bro.
Too. Him too.
That's one.
Acts 13 and 28. Men and brethren, children of the stock of Abraham.
Children, listen, children of the stock of Abraham.
What is this verse? Acts 13 and 26. Men and children, men and brethren, children of the stock of Abraham. And whosoever among you fears God, to you is the word of this salvation sent.
So, you need some help?
I got one for you, bro.
So,
that's
your question. You need that? You need that?
What was your reading?
8:13-14. Men and brethren, children of the stock of Abraham, and whosoever among you fear God, you is the word of this salvation.
The stock of Abraham is what? He's an Israelite. So if you think of Abraham, and he's on the Israelites. Whosoever.
Oh, wait. Abraham. Oh, my goodness. Right, why did I forget this? Okay, so Peter has a dream, right? Right, he has a dream.
Come on, read it.
They're talking about
before you get
days.
That, let me Isaiah 14:1. For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel.
Now, that's where that Romans, right?
Oh,
Paul quotes that in Romans 11. Listen, Paul quotes this in Romans 11. Listen.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
On Jacob.
And yet choose Israel.
And choose Israel.
And set them in their own land, and the strangers shall join hand with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob.
Exactly. That's some strangers, though. There's some scattered, them Israelites, foreigners. You got scattered.
You know who Jacob is?
They'll break this scripture down. Break this down, because you can't get around this scripture. This scripture got you cornered. Matthew 15:24. But he answered and said, now this is red letters, but he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. He told the disciples to wait, right? And then Peter had a dream, right?
Peter
had a dream. Did you just hear what I read?
Peter
had a dream, right? So you tell me the Lord changes his way. Mid, all of a sudden he just changes it up. Let me read it again, because you ain't comprehending it, bro. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
That's our point.
Didn't the Lord know everything? Why would he change up?
So why does it say lost? Why does it say they lost sheep? One of the 12 disciples, hold up, you're going to say he changed it up. One of the 12 disciples was called Simon the Canaanite.
Ooh!
Simon the Canaanite. It's in Matthew 10 chapter. You should know this. You're an expert, bro.
You're an expert.
You're supposed to give me knowledge. I am the expert.
You're supposed to give me knowledge.
I just told you. Matthew 10 chapter. Matthew the 10th chapter lists all the disciples.
Let me ask you.
And one of them was called a Canaanite.
So Peter has a dream from Jesus. From God, right?
After that, I'm going to read the scriptures.
Acts 11:18. When they heard these things, they held their peace and glorified God, saying, then have God also to the Gentiles granted repentance of life. Let's look at Isaiah 11:10. And in that day, it shall be a root of Jesse, which shall stand for an ensign of the people, to it shall the Gentiles seek the rest of the Lord. In that day, and the Lord shall set his hand again the second time to recover the remnant of his people.
His people.
Which shall not be left, from Syria, Egypt, from Patros, from Cush, and from Elam, and from Shinar, something like that.
He's all over the world.
You ain't paying attention, bro.
Okay.
Hey, you was over there thinking about something else, like that Dave Chappelle episode you talked about.
They little clown. He was thinking about dinner tonight, bro.
Right.
You ain't paying attention.
No, no, okay. So look. So the thing is, Peter has a dream, and God says he lays out all these unclean.
Just read it.
Wait.
Peter Cottontail.
You guys are ready to.
We do.
Yes, we do. That's what we are here.
Go ahead. Let it talk.
So Peter has a dream, and God lays out this whole table. It has unclean food, right? Right. Unclean food. So he eats. And God tells him to eat. And he's like, God, I've never eaten this ever since I was a kid. And God said, don't call what you say is unclean. Right? Is that about right? No. Why did Peter have that dream?
Because anybody not following the law, listen.
I'm telling you
why. Because anybody who's the one following the truth, they out here following idols, bro. What book is that written in?
This is
in
Acts.
Okay, and who's it talking about? Cornelius in the Acts of Tim Chad. Check Acts. Cornelius was a Latin? A Roman.
But,
and they was worshiping goddamn Zeus, Venus. So that's unclean. That's like a swallow.
He became a follower of Christ.
But you're not listening to me.
No, you're not.
That's why it's in here for swallowing.
Look, anybody who don't follow the truth is unclean, bro. But the Lord said that you can't call them unclean. Now it's time for him to come back into the...
But Cornelius wasn't a Jew.
Yes, he was, bro. He's an Israelite.
I'm just going to go with you, bro.
You know, the Pharisees described shit like that. They was looking at the Gentiles, like foreigners, that they was like shit, because some of them was bald-headed, some of them had tattoos, some of them ate pork, and then Paul was coming to them, and they was teaching them, and they was repenting, and they was looking like, these motherfuckers, like, who the fuck are these people? These people who put to death, they ain't supposed to be here right now. You know what I'm saying? Because they got tattoos and all that shit.
That's Nathan. They ain't got nobody. You can't repent under them niggas, man.
You
just blew me away with that one.
That's the word that they gave us.
It's in the Bible.
It's just a byword.
I get it out in the Apocrypha.
Yeah, I'm going to read them to Acts 10 and 1 with Cornelius.
I'll go ahead.
There was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian Band.
Italian Band.
Mr. Key. A devout man.
Devout man.
Devout.
They know he does devout.
And one that feared the Most High.
He feared the Most High.
With all his house.
So, fear what Most High? Is it talking about Zeus? What's his name? God's name is God.
Italian man.
He feared the God of Abraham,
precept
Isaac, and Jacob.
Precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little. That's how you know the truth coming out.
I had enough today.
Oh, he said he had enough. No, we ain't had enough.
We beat him down. We're trying to beat him down to build him up. Because we were all being beat down at one time. You know, for all the foolishness we were into. Go ahead, my man.
It's from Italian Band, right? It's Hebrews 13 and 24. So all them that have the rule over you, and all the saints, they are the Italian. Salute you. You are the saints.
Israelites. So hold up. And you had Israelites on record living in Carthage. You know where Carthage is, right? It's in northern Africa. You know where Hannibal, the great general, was from? That's way far away. But they're not Israelites because they moved. They moved to a different land. All of a sudden, now they're something different.
Yeah, we in America, though. We're not
right.
Israelites.
Oh, yeah.
Let me pray for you guys.
Who
are you praying to, bro? Right. Poseidon?
Praying the champions can get us anyway. No,
I'm praying for the champions can get us.
Okay, that's an enchantment.
He praying.
That's an enchantment thing.
Yeah, that's an enchantment, bro. Ain't no enchantments working against the house.
Where do you pray, man? That's what the camera say.
Hey, let me get that precept, bro.
You pray for the enchantment for the camera.
Enchantment for the camera? What's that? God, I ask you to just please go for God. I ask you to just lead them to all truth. Lead all men to all truth.
Right.
All truth. God, I ask you to just reveal the light to them.
We just gave the truth.
We've been reading scriptures all day, bro.
We didn't come out of our hearts, did we?
What is true?
But it's true.
Read Matthew 1 to the end of
John.
All right, bro. All
right, dog. Right,
wow. That's that effeminate spirit, man. That's why that homosexual thing messed with you.
When you get that report, man, you ain't no coming back.
He's trying to figure it out, I'm saying. Something, daddy.
There's too many.
You know what I'm saying? Something can happen.
Too many sperm cells floating around.
It's not.
Hey, you almost quit.
Yeah.
This is crazy out here.
Come here.
It's not. It sure ain't.
Well, I'm glad he left, to be honest with you. He's trying to give me a headache.
I wanted to read this for him, though, Proverbs 3 and 11. My son, despise not the chastity of the Lord. Neither be weary of his correction.
Right.
For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth.
So he kept talking about love your brother, love your brother. If you talking, bullshit, you gotta call someone out on your bullshit.
That's right. Even as the father the son in whom he delighted, happy is the man that findeth wisdom and the man that getteth understanding.
I was happy when I got corrected. When I found out they told me I was an Israelite.
Right, right.
Man, I didn't argue one bit, because I'm an Israelite.
Right. You was in awe. You was in awe.
I was in awe.
Right here, at the same bus stop, there was a summit or something going on. I see a dude. Hard on the phone. Man, I'm like, oh, shit.
Wow.
And I was like, I've never seen that in my life. Like, wow. You know what I'm saying? He went in on it.
Right.
And I was listening
right.
to what he's saying. White man didn't say back, like, yeah. I'm like,
We're convicting them of the truth, man. That's the gift the Lord gave us, man. And one day we all down and out. We ain't have no defense, literally no defense. And now we do. Now we got that defense. Where's that love, the Lord? Love is a fulfillment. Love, not your neighbor, in words.
That's in 1 John 4, I think. Maybe something like that. First John.
First John 4:3-18.
That's a proverb.
My little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth.
What is that, James?
First John
3:18. Oh, yeah,
I get a book deal.
Yeah, indeed.
Right.
They don't want. People always got a problem with the Israel thing, man. They don't understand. That's the spirit of when we first came out here. He was talking about New Jerusalem.
Look at this shit.
You read the Revelation. It's all talking about Israel. On the 12 gates on the New Jerusalem, you got the names of the Israelites on there.
What's up, Red Fox?
Ain't no ham mic.
You look like Red Fox, man. That was my dude, Red Fox. Yeah. Red Fox. Red Fox was getting paid, man. He said, y'all motherfuckers ain't paying me in checks. Y'all give me cash. Because he think he can get away with something, paying his taxes and shit.
They
hit him hard, man. He's a Jake, just rebelling Jake, man.
That's how they get all these Jakes, all these entertainers and musicians.
Well, it's like that he can buy another house overseas somewhere that he can deny the taxes he got to pay. Dick Gregory, a comedian, a master, I'll be chasing after him, he's clever, he's another fair kind of real clever, coming out with that black people and shit,
death threat to his family, when he told him, he said, come on, Sam, I need to come on the show.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. Ain't he like a professor or something?
Yeah, he was a comedian and he's a so-called freedom fighter.
Yeah.
But he started out. We hope to work.
That's what ushering Obama back for the third time.
Yeah, that's possible.
That would be beautiful.
And then they can set the FEMA camps out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. All that's coming regardless. Yeah. Whatever happens, it's coming.
Trump looks like me, like he's the one that's going to bring the hammer down.
Alright, this might get him out of here, because look, 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 he's trying, he set the border down, you know what I'm saying?
He's making shit happen.
He's trying to build the wall with the Mexicans.
Yeah.
You see how he's doing that, you know what I'm saying?
I've never heard impeachment talk this early.
You haven't heard it yet?
Well, I'm saying, besides right now, I've heard it while I'm saying, you know what I mean? Because like when Obama first came president, it was like, oh hell, Emperor Obama. You know, and everybody was with him. But now, as soon as Trump takes office day one, impeach him, that ain't never happened in history.
Yeah. And can you imagine it did happen, though? Not just Obama coming back in, but these people that love Trump, and that's, you know, that labor, you know, they bring a bit of arms for that.
They will. They're racist.
They're already talking now. They're talking now, man. So it's going to happen. We're praying for it to happen now, not just wait till next week, man.
No. I think Trump, he ain't fucking around. But he just doing that. He set a body elite anyway, though.
I forget what about things, you know, some revelations, but you know, some keep on telling me, keep on going when they talk about the Philadelphia. You know what I'm saying? The word Philadelphia, you know, the Church of Philadelphia.
It means brotherly love.
I know what that means, but I'm thinking, I'm just telling us to go to Philadelphia for some reason. I don't know, in my heart, telling me to go to Philly. My dad in Philly, he lived there. My brothers live in Philly. You know what I mean? I've never been there before, ever, but.
You gonna run into General Yohana.
Let's go to Philly. I don't know what it is.
This is Isaiah 5 and 19. Let me start off.
Because really those seven churches mentioned in Revelation, that's all brothers out teaching in reincarnation in different areas now, though. You know what I mean? Because them old churches, they're not even at the same spot they used to be.
There you go. Isaiah 5 and 18. Woe unto them that draw iniquity with cords of vanity and sin as it were with a cord rope. That say, let him make speed and hasten his work, that we may see it, and let the counsel of the Holy One of Israel draw nigh and come, that we may know it. Woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and light for darkness.
That was your boy that was up here.
Right, that put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. Woe unto them that are wise in their own eyes and prudent in their own sight. Yeah, that's how the spirit just went back to that family.
Yeah.
Woe unto them that are mighty to give drink wine and men of strength. To mingle strong drinkers.
Yeah, him coming up here talking that madness is like equal to sacrificing swine on the altar. You know what I mean?
Sacrificing food.
Yeah, that's a sacrifice of food right there. Talking that bullshit.
You should try to justify that concession.
Yeah, you can tell that dude.
Fuck that, man. That's crazy, man. That's crazy.
That shit's bad enough, man.
Fucking facts. And that's all I'm just trying to say. But that's why our insurance is so fucking high.
We made a video on that one.
Since shit, you know, pussies ain't supposed to be touching like that, man. You know? All that insurance. You got hops, man?
Huh?
You got hops?
Yeah,
I'm nice. My man. You know what I mean? Once you knew how to do something, then one day you don't have it no more, man. That's a fucked up feeling.
You think
man.
You got it? You go out there and somebody see you thinking right. You got it? That's my son. I'm like, oh, I don't even feel my feet legs up under me no more. I'm gonna fell on my face.
Yeah,
you
really?
Oh no, I'm a race.
For real.
Yeah, here you go. Basketball, man. You get fucked up when you get older.
This is 2 Peter 3:10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of person ought you to be in all holy conversation and godly?
Yeah, what manner of person ought you to be?
Let's go show some dope, man.
Oh no, let's go convince everybody that, right. that the Lord loves homosexuals.
Let's go rob that nigga that just come in.
I'm gonna turn away from my whole family, bro. You hear me? This word, bro.
Me too, bro.
Look what she did. She had a little contract where she can have people go do these moves and stuff, right, from this other company. So she can get people to go move and stuff, right? So she said, hey, won't you go move this stuff for me? You know what I'm saying? And I paid you, you know what I'm saying? Transfer the funds. The funds can transfer, bro, not a dollar from my wife.
She knew what she was doing.
Yeah,
she did that too.
Yeah, but who can do that? You know what I'm saying? That's like slavery. Right. You know what I'm saying? Is she darker than any one of us out here? I'm like, bro, you gotta eat in my spirit.
Right.
I said, your grandfather was a white man raped her. You know what I'm saying? Something happened in the slave fields.
Now, you got a lot of that. People, that's just something people don't even think about. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But that's just a curse of the under, man. Yeah. That's more reasons for you to get your ass out here with us and cross.
Yeah. Like, I'm with y'all, man. I'm not sitting on
you see us out here continuously, you know? Yeah. Everybody, all these brothers, man, these motherfuckers following us, man. Even though they continue to do wickedness, they support us, man, because when people come up against us, they be down there talking shit.
Right, like, a couple weeks ago, they was trying to come up against me because I look like a white dude or whatever, right?
Right, right.
And then they was taking up for it.
Right,
you
right.
You know what I mean?
Wicked motherfuckers.
Yeah, wicked.
Dang, I'm not a good reader, you know what I'm saying?
That's
I'm
good.
But I'm trying to learn the scripture.
Oh, that's all good, right? Because, look, we just had a brother dude that couldn't read at all until he started hanging with us, man. And next thing you know, he couldn't stop. We couldn't stop him from reading.
I can't read, but don't say I gotta go slow.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's all good, man. Better. The scripture says to bring in the dumb, the blind, the lame. You know? That's our people, man. You know, let me finish this real quick. This is verse 12. Looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of the Most High. Hasting. Praying. And we constantly praying.
In the early part of Exodus. It says stutter or stammering speech. Well, yeah, it said in Exodus, you know, Moses had a
stutter.
He couldn't even speak right. So he had Aaron speak for him.
That's your name, right? Aaron Richardson.
Oh, yeah.
My name, too, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, that's right. That's right. That's right.
How you say it in Hebrew?
Well, there's two ways to say it. I say Aharawa. Or even some people say Aharawa. There's two. In the Bible, there's two different ways to spell.
Exodus 4:10. Moses said unto Yahweh, "Oh, my Lord, I am not eloquent. Neither hear to for, nor since thou hast spoken unto thy servant, but I am slow of speech and slow of tongue."
And sometimes when we be out here speaking, and I start fucking words up, just make a fool out of yourself. You know, fuck, it's on the spirit.
Yeah, you ain't making a fool of yourself.
Well, you know what I mean, though, because people will laugh at you, like, that's why you can't talk right.
Yeah, they say, don't say,
somebody actually did say that.
I don't want nobody like, prove on things. I don't know exactly where to go in the Bible, you know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to learn.
That's why you got brothers. That's why you got brothers, man. Because we ain't gonna leave you out there hanging. You know what
I'm saying? It's all the spirit anyway, because at the end of the day, it's all the spirit. I mean, because you got a brother to know all the scriptures, know where everything is, and he got more scriptures memorized than everybody. And then he falls off and you don't even see the guy no more. You know what I mean? Because it ain't all about memorizing, who can memorize the most scriptures. It's all about the spirit. You know what I'm saying? That's the main thing.